Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy, which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord, and cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true. Fear not the imaginations against thee. Let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee. For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. Behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction. For wickedness hath exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled. Therefore, saith the Lord, I will hold my tongue no more as touching their wickedness, which they profanely commit, neither will I suffer them in those things which they wickedly exercise themselves. Behold, the innocent and righteous blood crieth unto me, and the souls of the just complain continually. And therefore, saith the Lord, I will surely avenge them, and receive unto me all the innocent blood from among them. Behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. I will not suffer them to dwell in the land of Egypt, but I will bring them with a mighty hand and stretched out arm, and smite Egypt with plagues as before, and will destroy all the land thereof. Egypt shall mourn, and the foundation of it shall be smitten with the plagues and punishment that God shall bring upon it. They that till the ground shall mourn, for their seed shall fail through the blasting and hail, and with a fearful constellation. Woe to the world and them that dwell therein! For the sword in their destruction draweth nigh, and one people shall stand up and fight against another, and swords in their hands. For there shall be sedition among men, and invading one another. They shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power. A man shall desire to go into a city, and shall not be able. For because their pride, the cities shall be troubled, the houses shall be destroyed, and men shall be afraid. A man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, but shall destroy their houses with the sword, and spoil their goods because of the lack of bread, and for great tribulation. Behold, saith God, I will call together all the kings of the earth to reverence me, which are from the rising of the sun, from the south, from the east, and Libanus, to turn themselves one against another, to repay the things that they have done to them. Like as they do yet this day unto my chosen, so will I also, in recompense in their bosom. Thus saith the Lord God, my right hand shall not spare the sinners, and my sword shall not seize over them that shed innocent blood upon the earth. The fire is gone forth from his wrath, and hath consumed the foundations of the earth, and the sinners, like the straw that is kindled. Woe to them that sin, and keep not my commandments, saith the Lord. I will not spare them. Go your way, ye children from the power. Defile not my sanctuary. For the Lord knoweth all them that sin against him, and therefore delivereth he unto death and destruction. For now are the plagues come upon the whole earth, and ye shall remain in them. For God shall not deliver you, because ye have sinned against him. Behold, an horrible vision, and the appearance thereof from the east, where the nations of the dragons of Arabia shall come out with many chariots, and the multitude of them shall be carried as the wind upon the earth, that all they which hear them may fear and tremble. Also, the Carmanians raging in wrath shall go forth as the wild boars of the wood, and with great power shall they come and join battle with them, and shall waste a portion of the land of the Assyrians. And then shall the dragons have the upper hand, remembering their nature. And if they shall turn themselves, conspiring together in great power to persecute them, then these shall be troubled, bled, and keep silence through their power, and shall flee. And from the land of the Assyrians shall the enemy besiege them, and consume some of them. And in their host shall be fear and dread, and strife among their kings. Behold, clouds from the east and from the north unto the south, and they are horrible to look upon, full of wrath and storm. They shall smite one another, and they shall smite down a great multitude of stars upon the earth, even their own star. And blood shall be from the sword unto the belly, and the dung of man unto the camel's hoof. And there shall be great fearfulness and trembling upon the earth, and they that see the wrath shall be afraid, and trembling shall come upon them. And then shall there come great storms from the south, and from the north, and another part from the west. And strong wind shall arise from the east, and shall open it, and the cloud which he raised up in wrath, and the star stirred to cause fear towards the east and the west wind shall be destroyed. The great and mighty cloud shall be puffed up full of wrath, and the star, that they may make all the earth afraid, and them that dwell therein. And they shall pour out over every high and eminent place a horrible star, fire and hail, and flying swords, and many waters, that all fields may be full, and all rivers with the abundance of great waters. And they shall break down the cities and walls, mountains and hills, trees of the wood, and grass of the meadows, and their corn. And they shall go steadfastly into Babylon, and make her afraid. They shall come to her, and besiege her, and the star, and all wrath shall they pour out upon her. Then shall the dust and smoke go up into the heavens, and all they that be about her shall bewail her. And they that remain under her shall do service unto them that have put her in fear. And thou, Asia, that art partaker of the hope of Babylon, and art the glory of her person, woe be unto thee, thou wretch, because thou hast made thyself like unto her, and hast decked thy daughters in whoredom, that they might please and glory in thy lovers, which have always desired to commit whoredom with thee. Thou hast followed her that is hated in her works and inventions, therefore, said God, I will send plagues upon thee, widowhood, poverty, famine, sword, and pestilence, to waste thy houses with destruction and death. And the glory of thy power shall be dried up as a flower, and the heat shall arise, is sent over thee. Thou shalt be weakened as a poor woman with stripes, and as one chastened with wounds, so that the mighty and lovers shall not be able to receive thee. Would I with jealousy have so proceeded against thee, saith the Lord, if thou hadst not always slain my chosen, exalting the stroke of thine hands, and slaying over their dead when thou wast drunken. Set forth the beauty of thy countenance. The reward of thy whoredom shall be in thy bosom, therefore thou shalt receive recompense, like as thou hast done unto my chosen, saith the Lord. Even so shall God do unto thee, and shall deliver thee into mischief. Thy children shall die of hunger, and thou shalt fall through the sword. Thy city shall be broken down, and all thine shall perish with the sword in the field. They that be in the mountains shall die of hunger, and eat their own flesh, and drink their own blood, for very hunger of bread and thirst of water. Thou as unhappy shall come through the sea and receive plagues again. And in the passage they shall rush on the idol city, and shall destroy some portion of thy land, and consume part of thy glory, and shall return to Babylon that was destroyed. And thou shalt be cast down by them as stubble, and they shall be unto thee as fire, and shall consume thee, and thy cities, thy land, and thy mountains, all thy woods, and thy fruitful trees shall they burn up with fire. Thy children shall they carry away captive, and look, what thou, they that spoil and mar the beauty of thy face. Woe be unto thee, Babylon and Asia, woe be unto thee, Egypt and Syria. Gird up yourselves with cloths of sack and hair, bewail your children, and be sorry, for your destruction is at hand. A sword is sent upon you, and who may turn it back? A fire is sent among you, and who may quench it? Plagues are sent unto you, and what is he that may drive them away? Many any man drive away any hungry lion in the wood? Or may any one quench the fire in stubble when it hath begun to burn? May one turn again the arrow that is shot of a strong archer? The mighty Lord sendeth the plagues, and who is he that can drive them away? A fire shall go forth from his wrath, and who is he that may quench it? He shall cast lightnings, and who shall not fear? He shall thunder, and who shall not be afraid? The Lord shall threaten, and who shall not be utterly beaten to powder at his presence? The earth quaketh, and the foundations thereof. The sea ariseth up with waves from the deep, and the waves of it are troubled, and the fishes thereof also, before the Lord, and before thy glory of his power. For strong is his right hand that bendeth the bow, his arrows that he shooteth are sharp, and shall not miss, when they begin to be shot into the ends of the world. Behold, the plagues are sent, and he shall not return again until they come upon the earth. The fire is kindled, and shall not be put out till it consume the foundations of the earth. like as an arrow which is shot of a mighty archer returneth not backwards, even so the plagues that shall be sent upon the earth shall not return again. Woe is me! Woe is me! Who will deliver me in those days? The beginning of sorrows and great mournings, the beginning of famine and great death, the beginning of wars, and the power shall stand in fear, the beginning of evils. What shall I do when these evils shall come? Behold, famine and plague, tribulation and anguish are sent as scourges for the amendment. But for all these things shall they not turn from their wickedness, nor be always mindful of the scourges. Behold, victuals shall be so cheap upon the earth that they shall think themselves to be in good case. Even then shall evils grow upon the earth, sword, famine, and great confusion. For many of them that dwell upon the earth shall perish of famine, and the other that escape the hunger shall the sword destroy. And the dead shall be cast out as dung, and there shall be no man to comfort them, for the earth shall be wasted, and the cities shall be cast down. There shall be no man left till the earth to sow it. The trees shall give fruit, and who shall gather them? The grapes shall ripen, and who shall tread them? For all places shall be desolate of men, so that one man shall desire to see another and to hear his voice. For of a city there shall be 10 left, and 2 of the field, which shall hide themselves in thick groves and in the clefts of the rocks. As in an orchard of the olives, every tree there are left 3 or 4 olives. Or as when a vineyard is gathered, there are some clusters of them that diligently seek through the vineyard. Even so in those days shall there be 3 or 4 left by them that search their houses with a sword. And the earth shall be laid waste, and the fields thereof shall wax old, and her ways and all her paths shall grow full of thorns, because no man shall travel through. The virgin shall mourn, having no bridegrooms. The women shall mourn, having no husbands. Their daughters shall mourn, having no helpers. In the war shall their bridegrooms be destroyed, and their husbands shall perish of famine. Hear now these things, and understand them, ye servants of the Lord. Behold, the word of the Lord, receive it. Believe not the gods of whom the Lord spake. Behold, the plagues draw nigh, and are not slack. As when a woman with child in the 9th month bringeth forth her son, with 2 or 3 hours of her birth great pains compass her womb, which pains, when the child cometh forth, they slack not a moment. Even so shall not the plagues be slack come upon the earth. And when the world shall mourn, and sorrow shall come upon it on every side. O my people, hear my word. Make you ready thy battle, and in those evils be even as pilgrims upon the earth. He that selleth, let him be as that fleeth away, and he that buyeth as one that will lose. He that occupieth merchandise, as he that hath no profit by it, and he that buildeth, as if he that shall not dwell therein. He that soweth, as if should not reap, and also he that planteth the vineyard, as he that shall not gather the grapes. They that marry, as they shall not get no children, and they that marry not, as the widowers, and therefore they that labor in vain. For strangers shall reap their fruits, and spoil their goods, and overthrow their houses, and make their children captives, for in captivity and famine shall they get children. And they that occupy their merchandise with robbery, the more they deck their cities, their houses, their possessions, and their own persons, the more I will be angry with them for their sins, saith the Lord. Like as a whore envieth a right and honest virtuous woman, so shall righteousness hate iniquity, when she decketh herself, and shall accuse her face to face. When he cometh that shall defend him diligently, searcheth out every sin upon earth. And therefore be ye not like thereunto, nor the works thereof. For yet a little, and iniquity shall be taken out of the earth, and righteousness shall reign among you. Let not the sinner say that he hath not sinned, for God shall burn coals of fire upon his head, which saith before the Lord God and his glory, I have not sinned. Behold, the Lord knoweth all the works of men, their imaginations, their thoughts, and their hearts, which spake but the word. Let the earth be made, and it was made. Let the heaven be made, and it was created. In his word were the stars made, and he knoweth the number of them. He searcheth the deep, and the treasures thereof. He hath measured the sea, and what it containeth. He hath shut the sea in the midst of the waters, and with his word hath he hung the earth upon the waters. He spreadeth out the heavens like a vault, Upon the waters hath he founded it. In the desert hath he made springs of waters and pools upon the tops of the mountains, that floods might pour down from the high rocks to water the earth. He made man, and put in his heart in the midst of his body, and gave him breath, life, and understanding. Yea, the Spirit of the Almighty God, which hath made all things, and searcheth out all the hidden things and the secrets of the earth. Surely he knoweth your inventions, and what ye think in your hearts, even them that sin, and would hide their sin. Therefore hath the Lord exactly searched out all of your works, and he will put you all to shame. And when your sins are brought forth, ye shall be ashamed before men, and your own sins shall you be accusers of that day. What will ye do? Or how will ye hide your sins before God and his angels? Behold, God himself is the judge, fear him. Leave off from your sins and forget your iniquities, to meddle no more with them forever. So shall God lead you forth and deliver you from all your trouble. For behold, the burning wrath of a great multitude is kindled over you, and they shall take away certain of you and feed you, being idle with things offered unto idols. And they that consent unto them shall be had in derision and in reproach, and trodden under foot. For there shall be in every place, and in the next cities, a great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord. They shall be like madmen, sparing none, but spoiling and destroying those that fear the Lord. For they shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses. Then shall be known who are my chosen, and they shall be tried as gold in the fire. Hear ye, O my beloved, saith the Lord, behold, the days of trouble are at hand, but I will deliver you from the same. Be not afraid, neither doubt, for God is your guide, and the guide of them who keep my commandments and precepts, saith the Lord God. Let not your sins weigh you down, and let not your iniquities lift up themselves. Woe be unto them that are bound with their sins and covered with their iniquities, like as a field is covered with bushes, and the path thereof covered with thorns, that no man may travel through. It is left undressed, and is cast into the fire to be consumed therewith. Amen. Thank you.